Hi guys, thank you for joining me. I'm running behind schedule and doing different reports. My son got a flat tire, and yeah, you think at his age he would have at least a jack, a lug wrench, or a spare tire, which he didn't. And where he parked, the asphalt was really soft. So I suggest that we call a tow truck to get someone to help lift the car because the jack kept sinking into the asphalt. So I really got behind in doing my work, which I enjoy, so it's not really work. Here we have an image looking towards the back basin from the Old Faithful live webcam. This is the sawmill complex. I don't know what's going on over there. They got a lot of people gathered up around this boardwalk. Yeah. But as you know, there was an 8.2 earthquake there up along the Aleutian Islands. I really don't think it was that large. I think USGS will revise it being lower somewhere down the road, and unless they want to deliberately cause a panic, and that's why they put it so high. The tsunami that it created was, maximum a half a foot tall. And it was only there where the earthquake occurred. But anyways, yeah, it did shake up the caldera here at Yellowstone. They have two areas where they're currently having swarms. Looks like they just posted a 0.7. 100 earthquakes in the last week. And then in the last day, we have 26. Here I'm using the program Swarm. This program was developed in cooperation with IRIS by USGS. And as you know, when they get an earthquake there, the computer picks it up and sends a message to the geologists who are supposed to investigate. So here's the earthquake as it came in at Yellowstone. It came in at 6:22. And 15 seconds. It actually occurred there at the Aleutian Islands at 6:15 and 47 seconds universal time. There was a Twitter post about how fast this earthquake moved. It says here the Alaskan earthquake produced shaking that moved the ground up to 10 centimeters a second. So that is almost 4 inches of movement, 3.9 inches of movement every second. And that's what they got. Doesn't sound huge, but imagine the entire landscape being shifted. Acceleration at half the force of gravity. Here at Maple Creek is the spectrogram of the earthquake as it came in. And let's just jump around here. Look at the heat that came up. I got a larger little, let me pull it over. Go back up. Maybe I'll just follow it along here. If I can keep on the line. Yeah, I've seen more activity. Magma heat coming up from Little West Thumb and the Promontory than what this earthquake created there at Yellowstone. But any earthquake has a 20% chance of creating another earthquake later, 20%. So that earthquake can be a foreshock for something much larger. Here we have Little West Thumb. And here's the earthquake, and we'll look at the spectrogram, and we'll pull it over. And I want to go down here to this other activity, if I can get the line. Like I said, the activity that's been going on there, at Little West Thumb and the Promontory has been much more significant than what this earthquake caused there at the park. But it could be the catalyst to set off an earthquake someplace else around the world or a volcanic eruption. An example, down in South America, there was a large earthquake that triggered a volcanic eruption miles and miles away. This activity has been going on for quite a while, and it's got nothing to do with the earthquake there. It's not being triggered, I should say. These are not earthquakes caused by earthquakes there in Alaska. 1729. So here's an example. Here's the earthquake there in Alaska. And this here is what was going on at Yellowstone hours before. Let me go over here. Yeah, lots of them marked in red. 1830. Now that was yesterday, universal time. And right here, I've talked about this before. This is magma that comes in so fast and so strong that the monitor goes quiet because it can't pick it up. It is beyond the limits of their machines there. Yeah, and it lasted a while. Let's see how long it lasted. Right there. Okay, 1831, 55 seconds. About a minute. I want to take a look at its signature. See, there's the earthquakes that were occurring, the blobs of magma that was coming in. Maple Creek had the same thing happening. See, these are blobs of magma. And let's take a look at the signature. I want to make this bigger. Looks like harmonic tremors. I'm just jumping around here during this time frame, looking at what was going on. We got volcanic and harmonic tremors. Here at the promontory, you can see the same thing was going on. All right, 1830. Doesn't look like it really kicked in until there at the promontory moved across. But the point being, I wanted to show you how the magma's coming across the park. Comes in from two different directions, the Snake River Plateau, and then up from the Gulf of California. Many of you might remember that report. Yeah, I'm just looking and comparing the time. I want to do this earthquake right here that USGS is not reporting. And this is before the 8.2 earthquake. It does show up on all three sites. We got Maple Creek, Little West Thumb, and the Promontory. That comes in as a magnitude 2.33, and I've shown you how there's been multiple magnitude 2 earthquakes that they're not reporting. And that's between 1 and 10 hertz. 2051, we got an earthquake that's also not being reported. It's marked in red. Let me make one of these bigger. Looks like we got a series of them right there. Yeah, bam, bam, real fast. And then we got this. Yeah, harmonic tremors. I want to go up to this one here. Two there. That one's got a long P wave on it. So does that one. It possibly could have been there at Sawtooth. We got another one there. And another one there. The most recent earthquake they are reporting is at 1614 and 25 seconds, a magnitude 0.7. 9 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 5 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. You can see it in blue there. And using Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. Over here we got Dot Island. This is an area here of a hydrothermal vent field. And I've talked about that before. And this is an area where they have a crack down underneath the crust of the earth where the rhyolite's trying to come up. And rhyolite is one of the most explosive types of magma that you could possibly have. because it's full of gas. So I made the promontory larger. There's a spectrogram. But I am sorry, I come up with a magnitude 2.02. Yeah, I have no idea how they came up with a 0.7. If you take out the majority of the seismic wave, yeah, you get a 0.74. This earthquake right here, they didn't fudge on. Hard to believe. Yep, they were honest. Maybe they just had one honest person that came in and worked for a short couple hours and left. But it's a 1.4, they say, by Silvergate, Montana. Using Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. Let me bring it out for you. Let's get an idea of where its location is at. Parker Peak up over here. Mirror Lake over there. And then right there is Yellowstone Lake. And over here, I often talk about Little West Thumb. And then down here is the promontory. Right there where it says Southeast Arm. That's the promontory. I come up with a 1.46. I'll bring it down so you can see it. Those of you that are watching on your TV, see it down there at the bottom? 1.46. But see, we got lots of other ones. I don't know. Let me see. Is this? Yeah, those are not being reported yet. Let me bring it back up. In the Mammoth Lake area today, in the last 24 hours, they got 18 earthquakes reported, the largest being a 1.9 at 10:31 Universal Time. Here we have Maple Creek. It's not 10:31. We got 10:24. Let me pull it over and see if I see anything at 10:31. No. Unless they're counting that little, let me go back, that little tiny blip. Anyways, what does this come in as? That one comes in as a 0.90. I don't know who the heck they got reading these charts. And then I just noticed we have Drumbeats going on. Yep. Drumbeats, a change in frequency of earthquakes may foretell explosive volcanic eruptions. According to studies, the seismic activity changes from steady drumbeats to increasingly rapid succession of tremors. These blend into continuous noise, which silences just before explosion, eruption. And that's what's showing here at Maple Creek. I'll bring this over for you. That is what's currently showing. Now, when Yellowstone had its eruption, its last major eruption, it did a counterclockwise unzipping of the caldera. We started out in the Madison River, Maple Creek area. Yeah, we got to keep an eye on this. So I just downloaded that, and we'll pull it across and look at the signatures. Boom, 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 boom. What, every 5 seconds it looks like, right there? And look at them all marked in red, too. Boom, boom, boom. That's a fairly long one. Went off the line, but yeah, it's a fairly large one. What's this one? Let me see if I can find that one. Yeah, oh my goodness. Yeah, screw waves. Blobs of magma. Harmonic tremors. Let me make that bigger. Look at that. Doesn't it look like a screw going up and down, up and down? Yeah, these are harmonic tremors at Maple Creek. Let's look at the spectrogram. Oh, okay, I have to make it small. Let me close it. And, oh, look at how hot that is, the magma. Yep. Yeah. All right, 5:39 Central Daylight Time. I just pulled this file. Let me come over and look. I don't see where it went silent, but this is very significant. All right, let me go over here. This activity just seems to be getting worse and worse and worse. Yeah, let me go over here. All right, let's go here. Anyways, I want to get this posted for you. Yeah, see, we got Drumbeats up in here. Yeah, all that through there. So if you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. I want to get this posted. I've had enough delays today. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.